हेलो देयर, दिस इज अमित कलंत्री एंड वेलकम टू द वॉल्यूम 1 ऑफ सेल्फ वर्किंग कार्ड ट्रिक्स. दीज आर नॉट जस्ट सेल्फ वर्किंग कार्ड ट्रिक्स, बट दीज ट्रिक्स कैन बी डन विद अ बोरोड शफल डेक. यू कैन गिव द कार्ड्स टू द स्पेक्टेटर एंड दे कैन शफल द कार्ड एंड देन यू कैन परफॉर्म ऑल ऑफ दीज ट्रिक्स. दीज ट्रिक्स डू नॉट रिक्वायर एनी नकल ब्रेकिंग मूव्स और एनी डिफिकल्ट स्लाइड ऑफ हैंड्स. So, I hope you learn these tricks well and amaze and surprise your audience with the killer card tricks. Thank you very much. Hi Priyanka.
Hi.
Are you ready to see the card tricks?
Yes.
Alright, so please shuffle the cards first. I always like, you know, I want myself to be fair, so I'm giving you cards to shuffle.
Anyhow, I can shuffle.
Yeah. Are you done?
Yes.
Alright, now watch this. Now, what I'm going to do is, like, I'm going to deal the cards like this, one by one. And you can stop me whenever you want.
Okay. Alright?
But before that, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take out the two cards of my choices.
Okay.
So, let me those special cards. Okay. They are kind of my prediction cards, alright?
Okay.
Yeah, so this is my first card and I need one more. I think I missed it. Yes, so I got my two cards, alright?
Okay.
Now Priyanka, watch this. I'm going to deal the cards. Whenever you want, you can stop me.
Yes. Stop.
Sure?
Yes.
Okay, so watch now. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to take this card and put it down.
Okay.
I'm keeping it face up.
Okay.
Now we will do it one more time. Whenever you want, you can stop me.
Stop.
Sure?
Yes.
Okay. The other card, I'm going to put face up.
Okay.
Now watch this. There are 52 cards in a deck.
Right.
Alright? But there are 26 pairs.
Okay.
Okay, so watch this. I'm going to take out that face down card and the card next to it.
Okay.
Okay. Same for the other card. The face down card and the card next to it.
Right.
So when I mentioned there are 26 pairs, it means the pair of 3 of heart would be
3 of diamonds.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Or 3 of diamond would be 3
of heart.
Okay. And the pair of 4 of clubs would be
4 of spades.
Yes. And watch Priyanka. You shuffled the cards.
Right.
You stopped the cards.
Yes.
But you stopped me at the pair of the 3 of diamond, and for the next card as well, you stopped me at the pair of the 4 of clubs.
Wow, that's great.
Yes. Do you like it?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, so Priyanka, are you ready to learn the secret of the card trick?
Yes, I'm very excited.
You're excited?
Yes. Alright,
so watch this. So, in the trick, you first ask a spectator to shuffle the cards.
Okay.
So, they will shuffle the card like this.
Okay.
So, what happens is, once they shuffle the card, what you basically do is you spot the top two cards. So in our case right now, it's Jack of Hearts and Six of Diamonds.
Okay.
Okay. So what I do is I basically show them that, you know, I'm going to deal the cards like this. And in that process, I keep the one top card at bottom. Okay.
Okay.
That is what you want. You can go with the whatever is natural position. Like you can spot the bottom card, which is already here, and the top card. But
okay,
I have changed the handling.
Okay,
from the original trick.
Okay.
So what I do is, I basically put one card down, showing them how to deal the cards. Okay, and then, so basically now, I notice the bottom card, which is a Jack of Heart, and the top card, which is a Six of Diamond. And when I tell you that I am going to take out my two cards, or prediction cards, basically what I do is, I take out the twin of this Jack of Heart, which would be Jack of Diamonds, and the twin of this top card. This is Six of Diamonds, so its pair would be
Six of Hearts.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I look for those two cards. Okay. And so Six of Hearts. Okay.
Right.
So when you take it out, don't show them first. First, you put it face down like this.
Okay.
Okay. And we are also looking for the Jack of Diamond. Okay. So as soon as we find the Jack of Diamond, we keep both the cards away.
Right.
Okay. People will not, I mean the spectator will not see these two cards.
Okay.
Now you must remember what is the bottom card right now. It's Jack of Heart.
Okay.
And Six of Diamonds. So remember the Jack of Heart.
Right.
Watch what happens. When I deal the card, so this top card, okay, this goes
down.
Okay, and we want that. This will come in the second phase. Okay. So watch now. See what happens.
Okay.
So stop me when everyone.
Stop.
Okay, yeah. So you are stopping me here.
Yeah.
Now what I'm doing, I'm taking this Jack of Diamond because the bottom card was Jack of Hearts. So this card should go first, which was originally at the bottom.
Okay.
So its pair should go here. Okay. This should be the first card, not the other card.
Okay.
Okay. So that I put face down. And what I do watch, I keep these other cards here.
Okay.
So basically what's happening, on this card is going.
Right.
Basically like this. Okay.
Right.
So I keep this card here.
Okay.
Okay. Now you can see the other card is set.
Right.
And we repeat this process. Okay.
Okay.
So stop me whenever you want.
Stop.
Sure.
Right.
Okay. And watch now. I take this other card, six of heart. I keep it here.
Okay.
And then I transfer these cards on top of this. So that gets set on top of that.
Okay.
Okay. And rest is just your acting, and you explain them that there are 52 cards, but there are 26 pairs, and which pair corresponds to which other pair.
Right.
And in the, okay. And you are way ahead now. You are all, the magic is already done. To take out both the cards next to each other, and you can snap your fingers and magically both the pairs will match.
That's cool.
Yeah, did you like
right.
it? Yes.
Yes.
Thank you. Hi Priyanka.
Hi.
Okay, so ready for the next trick?
Yes.
Okay, so yes. Take these cards, shuffle them. Okay. And as always, you can shuffle the cards.
Okay.
In all my tricks, I like people to shuffle the cards.
Done? Done.
Okay. Now, you can clearly see all these cards are shuffled. Am I right?
Right.
Okay. Now, what I want you to do, take these cards. And you know, Priyanka, in this, what we will do, I'm going to ask you three cards.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to control your mind in such a way that I'm going to ask you a name of a card and you will give me one by one. Okay?
Okay.
There's only one challenge for you, that you need to remember those three cards.
Okay.
Alright. So you know what I want now? I want you to give me Jack of Spades from the anywhere from the center. Jack of Spades. Don't look at it. I'll show you all the three cards at the end. So
okay.
From anywhere you like, give me Jack of Spades. Just in my hand.
Any card I have to give?
Yeah. No. Jack of Spades.
Jack of Spades.
You don't need to see it, but
okay.
I think you will give me exactly that card. So
okay.
Can I see that now? Wow. That's great. Okay. Now give me Eight of Clubs, Eight of Clubs from, you know, little from the top portion, but from center, yeah, little bit on the top portion, because first time you give me from the bottom, so that's why I want it from other place. So first card was Jack of Spades. The second I asked for Eight of Clubs. So remember those cards.
Yes.
Wow, this is really great. Okay, and now give me the top card as a Two of Diamond. Just don't look at it, just give it to me. Oops. Okay, I can't believe this.
Don't tell me, please.
Okay, can you tell me what three cards I ask you?
Jack of Spades.
One second. There is Jack of Spades. Next.
Eight of Clubs.
Are you sure?
Yes.
That's Eight of Clubs. And?
Two of Diamonds.
Two of Diamonds. You are a magician. Watch. Two of Diamonds.
Oh my God.
All three cards. Can you believe that?
How did you read my mind actually?
Yeah, that is the magic. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, so now we will learn that trick.
Okay.
Okay, watch this. So again, you ask a person to shuffle the cards.
Right.
Okay. And after they shuffle the cards, you show them, see, all the cards are mixed. Okay, but what you do in that process, you look at the top card.
Top card.
Five of clubs. So in our case now, it's five of clubs. Don't spread it much like this.
Okay.
They might spot it. Okay.
Okay.
So you just spread it like this and just spot the pick. Just take a pick of. So it's a five of clubs, which is a top card.
Right.
And as a magician, as a performer, you just remember that card in your mind.
Okay.
Now this trick is based on, it's called one ahead principle. Okay. So there are two things. You need to give the very clear instructions. So you have to say that I am going to ask you for three cards.
Hmm.
You cannot look at those cards.
Huh.
I will show them all. I will show you all the cards at the end.
Okay.
Okay. So watch this. So basically what happens is, watch. You give the cards to them, okay, and you tell them to give you any card from the center. So hold the cards in your hand. So what you say, you remember the top card, right?
Right.
So you ask that card as a card from the center.
Okay.
So I'll ask Priyanka, please give me five of clubs from anywhere from the center. From the bottom center, you can say that. Yeah. Okay. So yes, now you look at the card, okay, and you react that you are actually gave me five of clubs. So I react, yeah, really this is good. And actually, I did not get five of clubs. I got king of diamonds. Okay. But they don't do this. Okay. Huh. Now I will ask this card as the next card.
Okay.
Okay. So now I'll ask, give me from the top part, King of Diamonds, from anywhere from the center. Okay. Yes.
I cannot say this, right?
Yeah. And now this time I'll increase my reaction. Okay. I'll say, wow, this is really going good. Okay. And now what I do is, I ask this card, which is in our case Five of Hearts. Second card is Five of Hearts. Now I will ask this card as a top card, because I need to get my Five of Clubs into the cards.
Right.
Am I right?
Right?
So I ask, give me the top card as a Five of Heart. Don't look at it, I'll show you later. And then I go crazy and I say, I cannot believe this. Something like that.
Okay.
And then what you do in that process, can you just tell me what are those cards? Okay. And during the act, ask them to remember those cards. You can repeat those cards. Okay.
Okay.
And change the sequence of the cards casually. Okay.
Okay.
It's very casual move.
Hmm.
So what was the first card I asked you? Being the
Five of Clubs.
You keep that card. The next card, King of Diamonds. It was King of Diamonds
and Five of Hearts.
Okay. And they go, you get crazy reaction.
Actually, it does.
Yeah. It was such an easy trick, isn't it?
Easy, it was very easy.
Yes. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, Priyanka, take these cards and shuffle them.
Okay.
Nicely mix the cards.
Done.
Okay, now you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to turn over 4 cards from this deck. I'll show you that later, alright?
Okay.
Okay, so let's change the position of few cards. Yeah. Okay. So one is this. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Then another one would be this. Okay. Okay, I'm done with 2.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still looking for those particular card which I want. Sometimes I change my choice there. Okay. Yeah. Yes. I'm done. Okay, let me just check one more time. Did I do the right 4 cards which I wanted to turn on? Yes. Yeah, I'm done. Okay.
Okay.
Now Priyanka, I'm going to ask you one question.
Okay.
Okay. And I think your answer will match at least one of those cards.
Okay.
Not all 4. So
okay.
But at least one will match.
Okay.
So if I ask you this question, what card would you love to have in your dealt hand? When the cards are dealt to you, which card would you like to have in your hand?
Definitely aces.
Aces?
Yes.
You don't have any lucky number like 8,
No,
9,
aces 8. Are powerful in cards.
Okay, so you wanted aces. So I think then there is something wrong here. Because you can see, I got 9 was one of the number.
Ten.
Okay. Then 10 was one of the card which was kept down. This 5 was another number.
5.
And 2 was another. So nothing matches with your aces, right?
No.
Okay. So can I please correct this thing? Generally magicians don't go wrong, but this time I did. So can
yes.
I please correct this?
Yes, you can.
Yeah. So watch this. You can see. So all those 4 cards are not here. I'll keep these cards away. We don't need those cards.
Mm.
Now watch this. So this is 9. So we are going to spell 9. Okay,
okay,
so please spell
N-I-N-E.
Alright. Now next is 10. Okay. So that's T-E-N. 10. Okay. Next is
5.
Okay. This time I'll give you a choice. Do you want me to go spell F-I-V-E or should I go count 5 cards? You tell me.
Count 5 cards.
Are you sure?
Yes.
So watch 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay.
Mm.
What about 2? Do you want me to build 2 card or spell 2 card? Number spelling 2.
Cards.
2 cards? Okay, so 1, 2. Yeah?
Hmm.
Now watch. Your answer was aces. And I couldn't get it correct in first thing.
Right.
But you know, and I told you that this one will match.
Okay.
Okay, and I apologize that I got wrong first time. But you know, to just make that thing correct, this time, not only one card, but I am going to show you all the 4 cards which matches with your answer. And I am pretty sure that you would like these 4 aces in your hand. Right?
How did you do that?
Magic. Yes. Thank you. Okay, Priyanka. Now I'll show you that 4 aces act. Do you like it?
Yes, I want to learn that.
Okay, now watch this. So basically after they shuffle the cards, or they shuffle the cards, what you do, they can shuffle as well as they want. After that, what you do, you look for aces. Okay, so when you spot the first ace, what you do, you turn over the card which is left to it.
Okay.
Always, for all 4 aces. Okay, like this. Okay, so you do that, then you go for the next ace. Okay.
Okay.
And turn it over. The card which is left to the ace for all four aces, whatever is left to the ace. Okay? That is what you do. Sometimes if two aces are very close to each other, you have to separate them. Okay? During finding those cards, that action, you keep them away from each other. At least there should be 5 to 8 cards in between two aces, at least.
Okay.
You can keep more cards, but at least 5 to 8 cards should be there. Yeah. Okay, now watch this. Now you ask that question. You want their answer to be aces, actually. Okay, right. So you tell them, you ask them this question that which card you would like to in your hand. And you know, undeniably, anybody who understands the playing card, they will say aces, because they are the most powerful in our deck of hand. Okay, so this is what happens. Watch out. Because of our four cards, so when they answer aces, they will see nothing is matching with your aces. Okay, all four cards are different.
Right.
Nothing is ace there. But watch this now. So what you do, you separate the cards. So you take the face up cards till and the rest of the cards till you find the next face up cards like this. So that is one stack. And you can keep the other cards away. Then two like this.
Okay.
Then three and four. Okay. So you know, because at the start, when we did that thing, we have turned over the
left
card next to the ace. So you can see all the second card is aces right now. You can see. So the card which is right next to the face up card is ace. Okay, for all four stacks. Okay, you can see that. Aces. Okay. So see, this is what happens. Okay. Now you say this is Jack, and see, you put this down. This goes down. Okay, and you ask them. That I will spell this now. So it's Jack, J-A-C-K. So watch, this ace goes down. So now ace is getting set at the bottom. That J-A-C-K. Now the ace is down. And you keep rest of the cards here. Now if this is a small number, you can give them choice. Should I deal the 4 or should I spell it 4? But in this case, it won't matter, because F-O-U-R contains 4 letters. And if I count, 4. So it doesn't matter. Okay. So let's spell this time. Okay. So that's F-O-U-R. And you can see our second ace is down. Yeah.
Right.
Okay. Now, 10. So you can feel there are not 10 cards. So don't give them that choice here. Because if you deal 10 cards, there will not be 10 cards. Huh. Okay. So you say, I'll spell again. So that's T. So ace is going down. E, N, 10. Huh. So the third ace is down. And next is 9. Okay. So keep the face up card down and then you do. So our top card is ace. So we will spell 9. So that's N-I-N-E. Keep the rest of the cards here.
Okay.
And then you just do little acting. You say, I want to apologize for getting it wrong.
Yeah.
But you know, I said at least one will match. But you know, I want to go little ahead.
Yeah.
And to correct my mistake, I want to show you that all bottom four is are now aces. Okay? Easy enough?
That's what, very simple.
Simple?
Yes.
Thank you. Okay, Priyanka. Now we will go with the next act. Okay?
Yes.
You know, you can shuffle the cards. Actually, you can shuffle the cards. Shuffle it. In the next act, we will not be seeing the faces of the cards anyway. So it won't matter if you shuffle or don't. Okay? Yeah. So what I want you to do now, I want you to take few cards. Take few cards.
Like a card?
Yeah, but not many cards. Yeah, like, maybe, I don't know. Yeah, that's okay. Are you happy with those cards?
Yes.
I want to take a couple of more.
No, it's okay.
Okay? Take those cards. Please take those cards. And don't show me. Go turn that away. Turn that side and count your cards.
Count.
Yeah. Count. I will see that side. When you're done, let me know.
Yes, done.
Okay. Do you think I know those cards?
No.
Sure.
Yes.
Okay. Now you know, even I have taken out some cards. Okay. Let me count them. Okay, so I have counted my cards. Now can you just show me your thickness of your cards? Okay. I'm not trying to match those cards, but I am doing something, okay? I think I should add a couple of more cards to get my predictions correct.
Okay.
Okay, yes. Now I think I'm okay with this. Now I am keeping these cards away. Okay?
Okay.
Now watch. I'm going to make three statements, three predictions before we count our cards.
Yeah.
There would be three stacks.
Yeah.
Okay? In the first cards. Okay, in the first stack, you will count your cards.
Okay.
No, you will not count your cards. I will count my cards. So I'm saying in the first stack, my cards will match with your cards. So I will have the same number of cards which you have in the first stack.
Okay.
Plus, I will have two more in the second stack.
second stack?
Second stack, two more.
Okay.
Okay. And in the third stack, where whatever is left in my hand, when I will add to your hand, your remaining cards, the total would be 17. Okay?
17.
Yes. So I'll repeat myself again.
Yeah.
In the first stack, you will count your cards.
Okay.
Okay. In the second stack, I will count my card. And I'm saying my cards will match with your cards. I will deal the same number of cards which you are dealing. Okay. Then in the third stack, I will count two more cards.
Two more cards.
And then whatever is left in my hand, when added to your first stack, the total would be 17.
17.
Okay. So let's count your card in the first stack. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I will count now my cards. So I need to match those. Okay.
Right.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Right? Then I said two more extra cards in the third step. So 1, 2. Am I right?
Right.
And what I told, when remaining cards in my hand added to your cards, how many cards should be there?
17.
Okay, so how many cards are those?
10.
Now watch, count it. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17.
How is that possible?
Yes. With magic, everything is possible.
Actually, it's magic.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, now we will learn the explanation. Okay, so this trick is basically a mathematical trick.
Okay.
But we disguise in that principle in a card trick. Okay?
Okay.
We use that principle in a card trick. Okay. So people don't realize that it's a mathematics. Okay.
Okay.
And you know, there is a story about this, that you know, this trick kind of fooled Einstein. Okay. I cannot vouch for this, but it's that, you know, deceptive. Okay.
Okay.
Yes. So watch this. What happens is they can take as many cards they want. Let's you take some cards. Take this cards. Yeah. And what you do as a magician, you take more than their cards. That should be there. So you just look at that thickness and you take more cards than that. Okay? Like this. So I know my cards are more than your cards. Okay? Don't take the other cards. Keep them away. Now you ask them to count their card and you count your cards. So you just count it secretly. I will not look at that. Done? Okay, I have counted my cards. But you know what I do? Just to, you know, make it a little more deceptive, what I ask them to do, show me the stack and I will see mine. Okay? And I say, I know, I can do the act with the as many cards right now in my hand, but I still take a couple of more cards. I say, I think I need three more cards. I'm not trying to match your cards, but to, you know, get my predictions correct, I'm adding some more cards. So I think this feels just about right. Okay? Now, watch this. So now, right now, I got 21 cards in my hand.
Okay.
My cards, okay? Only I know this, you don't know this, okay?
Yes.
So basically what I do is, the two statements, first statement is this, always this. I will have the same number of cards which you have. Okay?
First statement.
We are going to make three stack. In the first stack, you will count your card. Okay? In the second stack, I will count my cards and they will be same as your number of cards. Okay? Then what I do is, the third stack, which is where I, in the performance, I said I will have
two more cards.
I can take any number. So I will take maybe three cards this time. Okay?
Okay.
So what I do is, I am going to take three cards. Okay. Then I will have three more cards. Okay?
Okay.
And what I do is, 21 minus 3 is 18.
18.
Then I say, whatever is cards are remaining in my hand, when added to your card, would be the addition would be 18. Is that simple?
Okay.
If I would have taken one more card, then 21 minus 1 would be 20. Then I would have said at the end, the remaining cards in my hand will, when added to your cards, will match, the total will be 20.
20.
So you can change that number. Even if you repeat this way, just change that number and you will have the different result altogether.
Okay.
So let's do. So I got 21. I said three statements. First, you will count your card. Okay. So my first prediction is I will have the same number of cards as you have.
Yes.
Then I will have three more.
Right.
And whatever is remaining in my hand, when added to your card, the total would be 18. Because what I'm doing is, from my total number of cards, I am deducting that extra card which I am saying, I will have 3 more or 2 more, that number I am deducting.
Right.
Okay. So 21 minus 3 is 18. Okay. So I will have 18 more cards added to your remaining, when I add to your cards.
Okay.
So count your cards now.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11.
Okay, now watch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Then I said I will have 3 more. Okay. that's 1, 2, 3. And when remaining cards in my hand added to your card, the total would be 18. So you got 11.
11.
No, that's 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18.
Okay.
Yeah, is that trick?
Yes.
Yes, yeah. Not only with cards, you can do the same act with anything. For example, if you have some coins at home, maybe you have marbles at home, or maybe peanuts at home. Ask them to take out some peanuts from your box, and you take some more peanuts, and you can do the same. It will match those numbers.
Actually, it is a
genius trick. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. All right, Priyanka. Ready to see the next act?
Yes.
Okay. Take this card and shuffle it. Yes. Now watch this. This is what you have to do. You have to take as many cards as you want. For example, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I will not see that. In fact, you can take those cards secretly. Okay, like this. Okay. So let's say you take 5 cards. Okay. And you will hide those cards.
Okay.
Maybe below the mat. Okay.
Okay.
And then after that, after you take out those cards, this is what you will do. You will count the cards like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you will look at the fifth card because you have taken out 5. If you take out the 7th card, you can look at the 7th card. Okay, doesn't matter. Okay, you will look at that card, but then you will go, you will pass on. Okay, you will pass some more cards because if you look at the that last card, in fact, you know what you can do? You can look at each and every card, but just remember the fifth card.
Okay.
Okay, like this. Why? Because you are taking out the 5 card. Hmm. If you take out the 7 cards, look at the 7th card and remember that card.
Okay.
Only that card. But just to confuse me, you have to look at all the cards, okay, and pass on and pass some more cards after your number. You're getting that?
Okay.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So shuffle the card one more time. You can shuffle the cards. Okay. And secretly take out some cards.
Okay.
I shouldn't even hear the sound. Okay. And hide those cards. That would be your number. Okay.
Yes.
Done? Hide those cards, please.
Beneath the mat.
Yeah. Done? Okay. Now keep those cards down. Yes. Now look at each and every card and remember the card which falls at that number. Understood?
Okay.
Yeah. And then pass some more cards. Yeah.
Bye.
Don't count.
Okay.
That's yeah. You count in your mind. Then stop whenever you want. You pass some more cards?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Now, this is what we will do. Keep these cards here, put those cards here. Okay. Now, watch this. Okay. Just think of that card. Okay. And I think. Okay, just look at that card. Okay. Alright, I think. Yes. If I'm not wrong, your card was black card.
Yes.
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 It was a number card.
Yes.
Yes. It was a clubs card. Can you announce what was your card?
5 of clubs.
5 of clubs. Yeah. And it did not see anything.
No.
And look at this.
OMG. How did you read my eyes actually?
Yes. Yeah. 5 of clubs. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so this explanation is another self-opening card trick. Okay?
Okay.
So this is the idea. It's self-opening. Even I don't know how it works, but it works every time. Okay. So idea is, you ask them to take out as many cards they want. Okay. Let's say they take out the 7 card. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I don't know this. Okay.
Yeah.
They're hiding these cards.
Yeah.
Right? I don't know this.
Mm-hmm.
Now watch. I ask them to look at the 7th card because they have taken out the 7th card now.
Right.
And pass on some more cards. Okay.
Yeah.
So watch. This is what they will do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and they will look at the 7th card, which in our case is Ace of Spades. Okay, they will remember this. And then they will pass on
some
more
cards.
But when they are doing the second action, I am counting those cards secretly. So right now I have already counted 9. Let's say they pass 10, 11, 12. Okay, so when they do that, I count those cards. So now I know there are 12 cards here. And to get their card, you just add what you do, you take these cards, keep it here. Keep those cards which are hidden, put it here, okay? And then you just add the cards which you counted, okay? Just add 1 to it. So that would be 30. And believe it or not, watch 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. Our card was Ace of Spades. Okay, and watch, it comes.
Okay.
I'll do it one more time.
Yes.
Let's say this time they take out 3 cards. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Hide these cards, please. Okay, I don't know about this. Okay. Now, what they will do, they will look at the 3 card. But while they are doing this, I am counting how many cards they have.
How many cards?
They will pass some more cards.
Right.
Okay, so watch. 1, 2. I am counting this secretly. Okay. So, third. So, they will remember 2 of hearts. Okay, and they will pass some more. So, I'm still counting. Okay. 4, 5. So, let's say here they stop. 5. So, I know my number is 5. So, I have to get their card. I will just add 1 to 5. That would be 6. So, I keep these cards first. Then, keep those cards on the top. So, our card was 2 of hearts. Okay, at 6th position. Because I counted 5, I added 1 more. Okay, so watch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2 of hearts. Works every time. Thank you. Okay, Priyanka, take these cards and shuffle them. Now, this next act which we are going to do, it's more based on your instinct. Okay. It depends, you know, it's even if the trick fails, I will not be responsible for this. Okay. Because I'll be using your choices, your instinct for this.
Okay.
So, you know, give me, take the uppermost half cards from that. We'll use just half cards.
Okay.
Yeah. And keep the other cards away. We don't need those cards. Now, this is what we are going to do. I will have this red card here. And the black card here. Now, this is what we are going to do. I'm going to take few cards like this. And you will tell me if you think these are red or black.
Okay,
and I will put those cards in that line. Understood? So, you tell me, what do you think? Is red or black?
Black.
Black? So, I keep these cards here, like this. Okay?
Okay.
Then next, I take this card. What do you think? Red or black?
Red.
Are you sure? See, you are right. Okay? Okay, fine. What about this? Red or black?
Red.
Sure? Red. What about these two cards?
Black.
Sure?
Yeah. Black.
Okay, we go some more. Red or black?
Red.
Okay. What about this? Red or black?
Black.
Black. What about this card?
Black.
Black? Yeah. Okay. Now you know you did that. Now we will change the position like this. Okay. Keep your hands away.
Yeah. Right.
We'll put the red card here now and the black card here. Fair enough? Now, tell me, what do you think? So now this time I'll put the black card here and red card here. So black or red, what do you think?
Black.
Sure? So I'll put the black card here and see your right. Okay. What about this, black or red?
Red.
Okay. What about this three cards?
I'm a magician.
Okay, black or red?
Black.
Sure? Okay, so black goes here now. These two.
Red.
Sure?
Red.
Black.
Red.
Or red. This.
Red.
Red?
Black.
Okay, yeah. What about these two? Black or red?
Red.
Red? Okay. Now watch this, okay? So they were red and blacks in my hand because you shuffled the card at the start. And then you made all the choices about red and black.
Right.
Okay? Now watch this. Okay. You can see. All these cards are black, isn't it?
Randomly saying red or black.
Really? No, but your instinct works, okay? And watch, all these are red cards. Not only that, but look at this, okay? All these are black cards. All these are red. So each and every card which you made a choice about, right. So you had a very good instinct.
My
congratulations. Yes. Thank you. Okay. So this is a very fascinating act. Okay. Where what you do, you ask a person to shuffle the cards.
Okay.
So they will shuffle the cards. You just take any half of the cards because they will, after a good shuffle, there will be a red collection of red and black in each deck. Okay, so we will just use half. It can be done with the whole deck, but it takes a lot of time. If you have time, you are casually sitting somewhere, then you can do with the whole deck. But I prefer to do it with the half deck. Okay, keep the half deck away, and they can cut the cards. All right. Now this is the idea. Watch. It's a very clever idea. So you can see they are red and black. So what you do? You take one red here and one black here, like this. But at the first phase, before switching the cards, okay, you only take out the red cards. Okay, so like this, watch. So red and black here.
Okay.
So watch. So you ask them, what do you think? If these are red or black? Okay, so let's say.
Red.
Right, so I'll keep it here. Then also, next time also, I'm going to take out the red card. So I'm doing this for the explanation, but you do it like this. Okay, don't show the people what you're doing. Okay, so yeah, what do you think? Red or black?
Black.
Sure. Mm-hmm. So see, it's wrong card, but I still keep it there. Okay? We'll correct it at the end. Okay. Then I take out two more cards. Red or black, what do you think?
Red.
So you know, sometimes I flash this. When it's going at correct stack, I flash purposely to tell them they are going in the right way. Okay, just couple of times. Yeah, red. The next card. Yeah. What do you think? Red or black?
Black.
Okay. And I have to keep I need to keep one red card left. Okay, it's important. Yeah, red or black.
Red.
I'll keep it here. Now see, I have got only red black.
Huh.
Only one red left. So what I'll do? I'll take. Now we'll switch the positions. So I'll keep the red here and any black card here. Okay.
Okay.
Now you tell them that this time I'm going to keep the black card this side and red this side. Okay. Huh. So now this time I got only black cards in mind. There's nothing, no red.
No
this
red.
Time. There was one actually. Okay. So just take it out for now. Okay. Yeah. So red and black. Imagine. Yeah. Okay. So red and black. Only you have to keep one card here to switch. Okay. Now you take this. You tell me black or red?
Red.
Red. So see, this time this is going wrong here.
Actually,
this is black, but still you do it. Okay. Then black or red?
Red.
Red. So keep it. Black or red?
Black.
So I'll keep it here. Okay. Black or red?
Red.
Red. So basically I'm taking out all the black.
All the black ones.
Yeah. Black or red?
Red.
So red?
Red.
Red. Black or red?
Black.
So I'll flash it one more time. See?
Okay.
Right. So they think they are saying correct. Black or red?
Black.
Black. What about these two?
Red.
Red. Okay, like this. Now see, this side is correct. When we started, there are red below this red, there are black
below
black. But here there are red below this black and there are black below this red.
Okay. It's alternate.
Yes. So what you do, first you show them like this, that they are correct. And they will be misdirected. They will see that all blacks are here and all reds are here, like this. To correct this, what you do, watch. You accept the top card. Accept the top card. You take all these cards, including this face up red cards. Okay. You take these cards and you give this move to this. Okay, like that. You just turn them over. Okay, one more time.
Yes.
So if this is the original position, accept the top card, black card. You take all these cards like this and you just flip them over. You show them, watch. See, all blacks are here and they won't realize this. And when they see here, see, all reds are here. Okay. This all looks correct. Isn't it easy trick?
It's very easy.
Yeah, and very, very attractive match.
Actually.
Yeah. Yes. Thank you.
I was saying.
Thank you. Okay, Priyanka, can you please shuffle those cards?
Yes.
Okay, now this is what I want you to do. Okay? Take out any card from anywhere. Don't look at it. Just keep it down here. Keep it here. Yes, keep it here. Yeah. And when I ask you, very side angle, just pick the card and remember the card.
Okay.
Okay. Please keep your card here. Alright. Now watch this. Okay. I'll keep these cards here. Alright. Now, this is what you do. I am going to deal you the cards and I will deal myself some cards. I am saying your card will land up in my side stack, not in your side stack. Okay, let's see. You got half cards, I got half cards.
Yes.
I am saying your card is in my stack. Okay. If you think your card is in your stack, maybe we'll bet. So, okay. So, if your card is in your stack, you will win. If your card is in my stack, I will win. So, would you like to bet something?
No.
Why?
50-50 chances.
50-50 chances. Okay. You're a smart girl. Fine. So, you know what I'll do? I will give you more chances. I mean, I will increase your probability.
Okay.
So, I will deal you some more cards. So you can see now my stack is getting reduced, isn't it?
Right.
Because I am just dealing the cards from my stack. Okay.
Right.
Yes. Okay. Now you can see you have fairly high cards than mine. So do you think I still say your card is in my stack, not in your stack. Would you like to bet something?
Okay, 400 rupees.
100 rupees. Oh,
yes.
That is not a interesting amount. It's a very small amount. You know, let's do something. I'll give you some more cards. Yeah. I'm not happy with the amount you bet. Okay. So I still think I mean, not think, I know your card is in my stack and not in your stack. Would I pick this amount?
Fair chances, 500.
500 you want to go?
Yes.
But that's still not enough for me. So, you know, I'll give you some more cards. Okay. Okay, I still think your card is in my stack. Would I pick this amount?
No, it's in my stack only, 1000.
1000? But no, let's go a little higher. Okay. I still say your card is in my stack, not in your stack.
Yeah, how much? One.
Yeah, I have one card. What do you think? You want to bet?
2000.
2000 rupees, yeah. Now this looks good. Okay, so what was your card?
Two of clubs.
If this is two of clubs, I get 2000 rupees, isn't it? And I win.
Wow.
Yeah. Thank you. Yes, but don't bet against the magicians. Yeah, okay. Priyanka, so did you like the betting trick?
Yes, okay. I want to learn that.
Yeah, so it's very simple, right? It's self-working. So first they will shuffle the cards as much as they want. Ask them to take out one card. Okay? And while they're doing that, what you have to do, you have to take out the 21 cards. Okay?
Okay.
So you can count in front of them or you can secretly count. You can count in stacks, like, you know, it will be faster. So 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18 and 21. Why 21 cards? Because we want their card at 22nd position. So I got 21 cards in my hand and keep it here. Okay, so just show the camera what is the card. Yes, and down like this. Yeah. 8 of diamonds. Yeah, so we'll keep this here and we'll keep these cards on the top. So their card is at the 22nd position from the top. Okay, now it's self-working now. So it was 8 of diamonds, now see what happens. Okay. You have to deal them the card first, because see, we have the even number, the 22 is even number, so odd even, 1, 2, odd even,
okay,
so 22 it will come in our stack at the initial counting, right? So just keep doing that, and every time you do this, you have to deal them the card first, okay? And you create the interest by asking them to, you know, bet some amount, so they will be, probably will be reluctant at the first, okay, because it's a 50-50 chances. Okay, so watch out. Okay. Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
So you can clearly see once again the 8 of diamond. Okay, is it should be in our stack, in my stack. You can see that 8 of diamond. It's here. No, don't take it out. So it's here. Don't change the position.
Okay.
Now watch. So they will not bet. So you say I'll give you some more cards. So you. So again, deal them the first. Don't deal yourself the first. Okay. That's very important. Every time you increase the amount in their stack, you deal them the first. Okay? So you can still see the 8 of diamond should be in my stack.
Yes.
Magician side stack. Okay? Now you give them some more cards. Deal them first. Okay? Don't do any mistake in your dealing. Okay? And you can still see the 8 of diamond is still here.
Yes.
Okay? Now watch. You get more interesting. And watch. See, the 8 of diamond is at the center. So obviously, second from position, so you give them one, you keep one, this is 8 of diamond and cards end. And you still say, your card is in my stack, will end up in my stack. And it will, 8 of diamond. Just remember, keep their card at the 22nd position from the top, and then just keep dealing the cards till you are left with one card. And it will be their chosen card. Yeah, easy enough?
Yes.
Thank you. Take these cards and shuffle them. So you can see all the tricks which I showed you today. I always ask you to shuffle the cards.
Yes.
Yes. So, yeah. Please keep shuffling the cards. Because there are always people who, you know, they like to see the magic after they shuffle the cards. So, I'm performing that kind of acts today. Okay. So, you're done?
Yes.
Okay. Now, this is what you will do, Priyanka. Okay. Watch. You know, you will go through these cards. Like, so, that you can see that all the cards are shuffled. What you'll do, you will take the card like this. For example, let's say you cut here. You can cut anywhere you like, and you will keep the cards like this. So I shouldn't see this card. You are going to remember this card wherever you cut. Let's say you cut here. So you can cut here, and you will keep the card like this. Just keep remember the bottom card.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So take these cards. Don't show me. No. Keep the cards. Spread the cards. Yeah. Spread the cards. Now cut it anywhere you like. Don't show me. Keep it close to you. Keep it close to you.
Yes.
Yes. And from the top side, keep that close to here. Yeah, take that stack and hide it there. Yes, are you done?
Yes.
Okay, now see. Sometimes you know what people think. Okay, you are done with that?
Yes.
So what you do, take those cards, keep it like this in your hand. Keep it. Remember your card, okay? And give it one cut. Give it one cut. Okay? One cut, complete cut. Yes. Done?
Yes, done.
Okay. Now, you know, people think I probably going the top card. Or maybe the bottom card, like this, okay? So what you do, cut anywhere you like and bury those cards inside that. So there is no way I could know what was your card.
I should bury this.
Bury this, yeah.
Okay.
Done? Yeah, so you did everything.
Yes.
In a watch this. See. I'm going to spread this card out now. This. Okay?
Yeah.
You should see all the cards. So can you tell me, are you looking at your card right now? Can you see? Is it visible? If it's hidden, let me know.
Yes, it's visible.
Visible, okay? Now keep your hand like this. Keep your hand like this. I'll just read your pulse to find your card. Okay? Not only doctors can read the pulse, but magicians can also read the pulse to find out your card. Okay? And you saw how fair it was when you selected a card. It was, and you buried that. There is no way I could know your card. Okay? But I can see, I'm getting no signal here, no strong pulse here, and no strong pulse here. So I'm pretty sure your card is still here.
Yes.
Right. Yeah. Okay. I can take out these cards. I'm pretty sure your card is still here.
Yes.
And yeah, I'm getting stronger pulse around here. Am I right?
Yes.
Right. Seven of hearts.
Yeah.
Is it?
Actually, yes. Are you a doctor?
No, I'm a magician. Thank you. Yeah. The explanation of this act is based on a key card thing, key card principle.
Okay.
So basically, after they shuffle the cards, okay, you tell them that, you know, all the cards are mixed. You can see that, okay? But what you do is you spot the top card, which is your key card. So in this case, it's four of hearts. Only
heart.
You will remember this. Okay, remember this. Four of hearts is your top card. Okay, but you know, this is a very deceptive trick. Even the magician get fooled by this trick. You know why? Because of this. So I ask them to cut the card anywhere and keep the card with their chest like this and remember the bottom card. So let's say this time they cut at 5 of hearts, okay? And they will be doing like this. And as a magician you will not be seeing this, okay? So they cut here 5 of hearts and remember and keep the other cards away, okay? Now see, I remember the top card which is queen of 4 of hearts and their card is 5 of hearts.
Okay,
because we have cut at 5 of hearts. I don't know about 5 of hearts. I just know 4 of hearts. So I ask them to cut the cards and see what's happening. Their bottom card, which they have looked at,
okay,
this bottom card, this will be go on the top of our key card, okay, like this, okay, like this. But then you tell them that, you know, people think I may be knowing the top card or bottom card. So what you do, take these cards and bury them. It will not matter because now my four of hearts is at the bottom of their selected card, okay, so just below their card. So ask them to cut the card anywhere and bury this stack here, like this, okay. And keep here. So because of this all cutting and mixing, they think it's very fair thing which we are doing. There is no way I could know, a magician could know
actually
where they cut the card.
Yeah.
And that's it. The trick is done. The next is just a presentational thing which I do by pulse. So I just look for my key card and you can see our key card was
four
of heart. Yeah. Okay, it was below this and see, you can see the five of heart is just above that card.
Okay.
So you spot that, you know their card now clearly. Just hold their hand and with some you say you are getting strong pulse here or there. So just take out some extra card from the bottom. You say you are not getting any pulse here. Then you say you are not getting any pulse here. Then take out some more cards. Okay, like this. Just keep reading the pulse and then you put their finger on the five of hearts.
So after it's below the key card. Okay.
Yeah, it's below the key card.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. To the left of the
key card.
Yes.
Okay.
Easy?
Yes.
Thank you. Okay. Please take this card and shuffle them.
Every time only I shuffle them.
Yeah. This is what I want. Can you shuffle? Okay.
Yes.
Now watch. This is what we are going to do. Okay. I am going to take out all the picture cards from this. Okay. We don't want picture cards. No confusion. Can see. So this time I just want to deal with numbers. Okay, so we are just taking ace. Ace is one. Ace stands for one. Okay. So I'll keep the aces while taking out all the picture cards.
we're just about the numbers. What he says. Yeah, so we don't want this. Okay, now take this card and you shuffle them, right?
Okay.
Now, no.
Already I shuffled.
Yeah. So you now deal the cards one by one.
Okay.
Yeah. One by one, deal the cards. Deal the cards. Yeah, like that. Yes, perfect. Keep going on. Now you can take the card from center as well if you want. And stop whenever you want. You can take the card from anywhere you like.
Okay. Yeah. I can take from
take few cards, yeah, anywhere you like. Yes. Top, bottom, middle, doesn't matter. Yeah, you can keep the bunch as well, doesn't matter. Are you done?
Hmm.
Yes. Keep those cards away as well.
This.
So yeah. Okay. Yes. So these are the cards which you selected.
Hmm.
Keep them properly. Take it in your hand. Now I want to divide them into three stacks. So one by one. Yes. One, then one more, one. And finish the stack. On top of each other, one second. On top of each other, like this.
Okay.
Yeah. Finish them. Yes, perfect. Yes, okay. Right now it ended up here, but sometimes it might even end here. Depends on how many cards you selected. Okay, so watch this. So Priyanka, you shuffled the cards.
Yes.
We have taken out the picture cards.
Yes.
Then you took out how many cards you wanted.
Yes.
Isn't it? Now watch. If I'm just go here. This time I'll just know the numbers, okay? So I'm saying this number. 923. So I'm saying this card is 9, this 2 and this is 3. Shall we see this? This top card.
Okay.
9. Okay. Then I said
2.
That's 2. And
3.
3. And 3.
Wow.
Yes. Thank you. So now we learn the explanation of this act.
Okay.
So it's a very simple act to do. So they will shuffle the cards as much as they want. What you do is you actually say that we are going to take out the picture card, but that is an important thing. In that process, you do something which I'll tell you. So you say that we are going to take out all the picture cards. It gives you a very good reason to spot the top three cards. Okay?
Okay.
Yes. So you do this thing, take out all the picture cards, you look for them, and you tell them this is just about this act is just about number. That's why you're taking out the pictures. Okay? So picture cards. So you can see now what are the top three cards in our case. It's 1, 1, 2. Ace, 2. Just remember that. You can remember top three cards, exact the number and suit, but it's too much to do that. Sometimes you can forget a card and then it can go wrong. So I prefer to do with just the number. So it's ace, and 2. So I remember the numbers 1, 1, 2. That's it. Okay. And watch this. So these picture cards go out of the thing. Now watch. Take the cards and deal the cards. Show them that you have to deal the cards one by one. So deal. So what I do, once they start dealing, I let the top three cards go first. So deal the cards. Yes. So once again, so my 1, 1, 2 are here now.
Here.
Now keep dealing. Yeah. So you can take out the cards from anywhere.
Okay.
Now I say that.
Okay.
After the three cards are passed, take out the card from center, anywhere you like, and stop there whenever you want. You can take out bunch from there or maybe one card, doesn't matter. You can deal a couple of more if you want. Yes. Are you okay?
Yes.
Keep those cards away. Okay, so now these are the cards they think. So you know it's a very good mixture of cards because they have they were dealing the cards, they are taking the cards from different places. So that is what they remember, that they separately took out the cards. But now my bottom cards, 1, 1, 2 are at the bottom. Those three cards. Okay.
Yeah.
And now this will work automatically. Now divide them into three stacks. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, and finish the deck. So what will happen in this process? On the top of each other. Okay. Yeah. Automatically, top three cards will go each card on each stack. So when three cards are left, let me know. Yeah.
These are three cards.
Yeah. So watch. You can see. One ace is here. No. Yeah. Two.
It's
correct. This side. Two is here.
One, one, two.
Okay. So that this will be one. Yeah. And this will be one. So you can
okay.
see. And you have to remember where the first card finishes. So the last card finishes. So last card is finishing here. So in that sequence, it will be 1, 1, 2.
Right.
Okay. Because that is what the sequence at the original. The first two aces and then two. So you can see the top card would be one, then the second is one, and this is two. Okay? And you do that by just doing some magical action. You say, okay, let me just sense something. And I think if I'm not wrong, it's 1, 1, 2. So this would be one, ace, this would be ace, one more time, and this would be two. And it will work every time.
Amazing.
Yeah. Thank you. Priyanka, please shuffle those cards.
I'm going to shuffle for more time this time.
Why not? You can refresh shuffle if you need. Yes, alright. So watch this. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to divide the deck into four stacks, almost containing equal number of cards. Mm-hmm. This would be one of our stacks. Mm-hmm. Okay, this would be one of our stacks. This would be one of our stacks. This would be one of our stacks. Four. But I think there are some more cards left. Keep some cards here. Yeah, I'll add to this some more. This. And some more to this. Now this looks almost okay. Okay?
Thank you
so much. Now, I'll keep giving proper things here. Okay, so these are the four stacks. After you shuffle the card. Mm-hmm. What I want you to do, okay, I want you to cut this way, these two. Keep it here. Cut it, keep it here. Take this, keep it here. Okay, now take one card, put it here. Take one card, put it there. Take this stack, put it there. Yeah, you have to do lots of cutting here. Take this stack, put it there. Take this stack, put it there. Now divide this into half, both the cards. Into half. Divide into half. Yes. Take this card, put it there. Only one card. Top card, put
one
it there.
Card.
Yeah.
Okay.
Put one card here.
Okay.
Take this card, put it there. Yeah. Take one card, put it there.
One card.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Take this stack, put it there.
Ah, that's confusing.
It's okay. Put these cards there.
Okay.
Yes. Now divide this into half.
Again?
Yeah. Yes. Divide this into half.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now take one stack, put it there. So one, no, one card, put it there.
One card.
One card, put it there. Yeah.
Ah.
Take one card, put it there.
Ah.
Yeah. Put one card, put it there. Take half cards and put it there. Take this stack, put it there.
Stack?
Yeah, whole stack, put it there. Take this stack, put it there. Take that stack and put it there. Yes, so you can clearly see it cannot be more clear than that. It was like complete mixing and messing of the cards, right?
Right.
So watch, now watch this, okay? You did everything, okay? Watch. No. Okay, I'll just keep the cards here. Watch this. This, you already know what's going to happen, right?
Yeah.
See that?
No.
Yeah.
How is that possible?
And all four aces.
I shuffled myself.
Yes, yeah. That is what magic is about.
And it was a random shuffle.
Yeah, I know. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so now we will learn that four aces amazing magic trick. Okay.
Yes.
It's very easy to do. So after they shuffle the cards, they can shuffle the cards. What you tell them that you are going to divide them into equal four stacks.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But what you do basically, you look for an ace and you cut there and you put it there.
Mm-hmm.
In our case, what was happening was they all four aces were very close to each other. So I had to, you know, do some shuffling here and there.
Yes.
But if like around 10-15 cards are below one ace, that's okay. So you take and keep that stack. So now you can see the ace is on the ground. Okay. Now see, you can see it's not right. I cannot make the stack of two. So what I do, I take and add some card here so that my ace is on the top.
Yeah.
Can see this?
Yeah.
Okay, so this would be my second stack.
Okay.
Okay. Then I look for the third ace, which is here.
Yeah.
I can take here. And then look for four. I can just transfer it to a top. And you are doing it here. They will not see what you are doing.
Yeah.
You just tell them that, you know, I am just trying to divide into four equal stacks.
Mm.
So now this, every time I perform this trick, you won't believe. I don't know how many times I ask person to cut.
Yeah.
Okay. There's only one thing which you have to do. You have to just keep the track of the aces. That is the only thing you need here.
Okay.
So watch. So now, four aces are on the top, that I know, okay? But they don't know. So they thought it's all mixed cards and I just divided it into four stacks. Okay, so already four aces are on the top. There it is setting.
Yes.
Now I ask to cut them into half. So they will cut it like this, they will cut it like this. So now can you tell me where are the aces?
Yeah.
Here. So these stacks, we can do anything with this. So what I ask them to take one card and put it here. Okay. Then I ask to take one card and put on this stack. So now watch, this is our ace.
Yes.
And this is also ace.
Ah.
Okay. So because I asked him to keep this card here, now there are two aces here.
Two aces.
Now these three stacks are, you know, irrelevant. You can do anything. So I asked him to cut some cards here, put one card here, put this card stack here, then put this stack here, then put this stack here. So I want my aces on the top again. So now you can see there are two aces here.
Together. Yes.
Now you ask them to cut these cards again, like this. Okay? Like this. Okay? You can even ask them to cut this into three stacks. It doesn't matter. Okay, you can do anything. In our performance, I went with 2-2. So
okay,
we can do that. So you now our two aces are here.
Aces are here.
Yeah. These are irrelevant stacks. So I do same thing again. ask them to take one card here, cut it here.
Right.
And ask this card, take the one card and put it here.
Right.
So now two aces are here. Now
right.
These three stacks are irrelevant.
Right.
So ask them to cut this card, put it here, cut some cards here, put it here, then take this stack, put it there, take this stack, put it there.
Yeah.
Every time I change this, even
yes.
I don't remember. I just keep the track. Then now there are two aces here,
and
two aces are here. Now I ask them to put this stack here.
Hmm.
Now what I ask them again, please divide this into two stacks like this.
Yeah.
Okay. So now my two aces are here.
Two.
Now I do that same thing. I ask them to cut one card here.
Hmm.
Then I ask them to put one card here. Then I ask them to. So now there are three aces.
Three aces.
One ace is still here.
Hmm.
Then I ask them to take this card here, half card, and put it here.
Hmm.
And I ask them to take one card and put it here. So now my all four aces are here.
Mm.
Now I ask them to cut this card here.
Mm.
Then I ask them to put these cards here.
Mm.
Then this stack here.
Mm.
And watch. This stack should go up because all my four aces are here. Okay. And because of that, all cutting and mixing, they think it's like completely messed.
Huh.
Okay. But when you ask them to open the top four cards, or you can do it yourself, and they see all four aces pops up on the top. What do you think?
How did you do that?
Yes.
It's confusing.
It's not. It's confusing for the audience.
It's working.
It's working. Yeah. Every time it works, yes. Unless you make a mistake, it will not go wrong.
Yeah, you should be careful.
Yeah, not careful, just keep the track of the aces.
Okay.
I hope you liked it.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you so much.